Hey guys, it's Ileane from basicblogtips.com. Today I want to talk to you about the Google Chrome browser and how you can set your browser up for success so you can be a power user on Google Chrome. I want to show you some tips to help you be more efficient, and toward the end I'm going to give you a special bonus tip that's going to make you feel like a real power user when it comes to Google Chrome. When you open a blank tab in Chrome, you would get a display of all your applications that you have installed, as well as access to the Google Chrome store, where you can find more handy applications and extensions. But one of the updates that they rolled out in the fall of 2013 was to change the home screen for a blank tab, and now it looks like this. So the first tip I want to give you is, even though this browser should update automatically, sometimes it doesn't. So I want you to move over to the top of the page and come down and open up your settings bar and do About Google Chrome. This is going to check to make sure that you have the up-to-date browser, and then you'll get the message to let you know that it's up-to-date. So anytime you find that things are behaving a little strangely, go up and make sure that it's up-to-date. Now this new blank tab does have some cool features, lets you do the Google search, but it also remembers your browsing history. So it's going to show you those pages that you visit most often. They also added a handy feature up in your toolbar to get you back to the apps page. And that's just a link right here. Now I've showed this in a previous video. If you want to see your extensions, and there's just a little subtle difference between your Chrome extensions and your apps, you can install the link right on your browser bar for extensions. And always check off this developer mode. That's just going to give you, if there's any extra features or anything new rolling out, that'll give you access. If you find that there's an extension that you just don't really like and you haven't really been using it, you can easily disable it right here. Now, if you completely don't want to have anything to do with the app anymore, you can delete it here. Now, Hootsuite, they're another one who's always constantly innovating. And they just made some recent changes to the Hootsuite Hootlet. But there's options with that. So if you want to check on the options, always look to see what those options are and toggle off any features that you don't want. Now let's turn our attention back to this browser bar. And you'll notice something that I've done here. See these bookmarks that I have right here? Notice that they don't have any words next to them. That just gives you more room on your browser bar. If you know certain icons or the fav icon of certain sites that you visit often, you can simply remove the words. For example, this one is for Blog Engage. You shortcut click, open up Edit, and see, I know the fav icon for Blog Engage, so I don't need that to have any letters. This next tip is going to save you time anytime you want to add a new bookmarklet. So right now, over on Triber, and this is my tribe over in Triber, and you simply come up to the Omni box, that's what this space is called, it's called an Omni box, and drag it down. There you go, and then we can edit that, get rid of the name. Now you have another quick way to get to your favorite sites. Doesn't take up that much space on your bookmarks bar. Moving on to the next tip I want to share with you, it's actually an extension and it's called Shortcuts for Google. And this extension allows you to add any of the Google services that you want. It's just a quicker way to navigate around on Chrome and get easier access to all of the bookmarks and sites that you use, especially Google. And here's the options page. And you can see where this is all of the available Google services. You can just drag them over. Another option that I love about this extension is you can simply add a website. For example, I added my Facebook page. So now I have easy access to go directly to my page right from Shortcuts for Google. So now let's go over to our power tips. And for those, we're going to access the settings on Chrome. In the first section on startup, this is where you're going to set the page that you always want whenever you open up Chrome. And for me, it's going to be basic blog tips, which is my blog. You can also add additional pages that will open up every time you open your browser. So what we're going to do is we want to get access to those apps very quickly. So we're going to add the URL for the apps. Come over to that apps page. Grab that URL. Go back to our settings page, add it in. Now let's shut down the browser and open it back up. And you'll see my home page opened, as well as that apps page, which I desperately want to have access to as quickly as possible so I can go and check my email and any other sites that I want to visit right away. That's it for today, guys. Hope you're able to navigate your Google Chrome more efficiently. Talk to you soon. Sign up for my newsletter. That way you can stay on top of all the latest with blogging, social media, YouTube, and podcasting. And in order to sign up, just go over to basicblogtips.com/email. And I'll chat with you soon.